Then Ayade come from crossing the state.
Please let me see.
Thank you.
Your Excellency,
the very Dr. Danju, Chairman Investment Promotion Motiva, DGBPB. Gentlemen, I welcome you to the conference room of His Excellency here for an interactive meeting, and it's going to be for a brief remarks.
Your Excellency, this presence has been enhanced through a formal relationship with the state government, as is evidenced by a memorandum of understanding which was executed between the two parties in December 2012. The MOU, which was based on the resonance between the mandate of the bank and that of the state as represented by MEDA, is meant to make available affordable and sustainable financial resources to youth, women, and business cooperatives engaged in business activities at the micro level in the state. Your Excellency, as highlighted before, finance has been a major challenge for businesses, especially the micro and medium variant in the state. To address this challenge, MEDA sets out to source for affordable and reliable finance for unemployed youth to start or grow their business enterprises, which are the bedrock of the private sector. In pursuit of their goal objective, the state government through MEDA in April of 2012 executed an MOU and set up an MSME fund with the state government and the bank to create available sources of income for micro, small, and medium enterprises. We had first of all set up a similar fund with the Bank of Industry, where the money was meant for those in manufacturing and value addition. Now, we later discovered that that fund had left out a greater chunk of the business community who are involved in primary production. It was on that basis that we got into engaging with the Bank of Agri and set up this fund. So the fund was set up with an initial 200 million naira contributed equally by the state government and the Bank of Agriculture. And it is currently disbursed through the four BOA branches in the state. And the branches are in Calabar, Akamba, Apiapo, and Okoja. Presently, the fund has disbursed about 190 million to 2,364 micro businesses across the state. In terms,
2,364, yes, you know, just for the sake of saying you have given money out. So, serious country. Why would you do that? Why would you do that? Just to see, collect, at the fullness of time, you can see when he was the MD of the Bank of Industry. I was able to start another account. Today is exporting. You have a story to tell. Yes, not. Yes, not. Every people, 2,000 people. 2,000.
an additional 200 million to enable more people to benefit from the scheme. The additional 200 million was to be contributed equally by the Cross-River State Government and the Bank of Agriculture. Despite the approval of the former governor, the enhancements could not materialize as at the time the government wound up its term. Your Excellency, this scheme attracted a lot of acceptability across the state, and we humbly request approval so that we would rejig the scheme and see how we would take it to meet the expectations of Your Excellency. The scheme, which is to enhance access to finance by MSMEs, increase their productivity, expand employment opportunities, and create wealth in the society. And this fits into your goal, which is to create wealth, reduce unemployment, and provide self-reliance to the people of the state. We wish to observe that the current MOU with the bank, which was executed in 2013, is due for a review. Specifically, the MOU did not have provision for appointment of external auditors and mid-term review. These are some other issues we have started discussing with the bank, and with your permission, Your Excellency, we would like to incorporate like what you have just mentioned so that the MOU will be revised. Your Excellency, with the visionary and exemplary leadership that has been shown by administration, MEDA is poised to build on the existing relationship with the bank and other partners and develop new ones to further the aspirations of this administration. We believe Bank of Agriculture has the capacity to be involved in all the laudable programs in agro-based industries. Specifically, sir, Bank of Agriculture could not only support the special purpose companies that are being set up for rice, cocoa, maize, banana, livestock, etc., but can also support backward and forward integration for micro, small and medium enterprises in their value chains. Through these partnerships we are reorienting our youth towards being self-employed, and we have also created and supported new enterprises that provide jobs. Finally, Your Excellency, due to the number of beneficiaries that are in the scheme that are spread along all the 18 local government areas and the bank's potential going forward in the state, we have requested that the bank should consider opening new branch offices as the current four are grossly inadequate. We believe a branch in Obudu can cover Obanipo and Bekwara local government areas and release pressure from the branch in Abuja. Also, there's a need for a branch in Ikon and Akpabio to cover Ikon, Etun, and parts of Oki and Akpabio and Bakasi, respectively. We want to once again thank Your Excellency for giving us this opportunity. Thank you, sir.
To also leave my other engagements in Abuja to come down, because I see that we have very dynamic, progressive people looking forward, addressing the serious challenges that our country and the different constituent parts of the country face. The relative underperformance of the agricultural sector, there is really need for a serious investment, both in terms of finance and human resources, as well as the institutional structures, to ensure that our economy is truly diversified, our youth, as well as women, are gainfully employed, and the issues of poverty are addressed. I take it that the Bank of Agriculture is one such institution, and its current status reflects the relative neglect of agriculture in general in our country, and the real sector in particular. The Bank of Agriculture was set up about 14 years ago and is owned by the Ministry of Finance, and the Central Bank of Nigeria. Its main purpose is to support agric as well as SMEs in our country. Financing is the main function of the bank. And like we all know, Your Excellency, finance is the lifeblood of the modern market economy. Lack of access to finance is the source of the relative underperformance of several components of our economy. And it's important that we get this right, because other countries that have managed to channel resources to the real sector, in particular agriculture, have diversified the economy, ensured food security, and have therefore laid the foundation for the industrial takeout of those countries. Nigeria should also be so. In this respect, the Bank of Agriculture, although it has the largest concentration of specialists in agriculture, it also has relatively limited resources to undertake the serious task of transforming our economy by supporting the agricultural value chain, in particular, and to our country at large. We have a whole range of products, ranging from SMEs to agribusiness across the value chain. We are also introducing new sets of products, including program to ensure agriculture 365 days a year, year round, several rounds of crop production. We're also coming up with programs that will support the establishment of rural infrastructure to form the bedrock of supporting agricultural policies across the different parts of the country. Your Excellency, one particular product that I think would be of interest to the state government is the Uncle's Borrowers Program, which was backed up by the President of the country, President Muhammadu Buhari, in Kebbi, which I'm pretty sure, given my preliminary discussions with the MD of MEDA, the Honourable Commissioner of Agriculture, and indeed the Honourable Commissioner of Industry, Cross River State is more than ready to assist the fund. The Central Bank of Nigeria, under the current governor, has set aside over 200 billion naira for states to assess. I think, Your Excellency, this is the amount of fund, the kind of money that is needed, which even at this level, I can understand, Your Excellency, the kind of dissatisfaction with the way our country has been tackling the issue of agriculture. The amount, if you look at it, it's not significant if you see the demand that, the scale of resources that we need if we have to feed our people to ensure that there is full employment across rural and urban areas, and to generally lay the foundation for the industrial takeoff of our country. So these funds are available, and what is required is a framework to assess it. We've started discussing, and we will seek the approval of His Excellency that Cross River be the next beneficiary of this resource. It will create thousands of employment for both the youth, women, and especially in the rural areas and in the productive sector. It's something that can be replicated over and over. And we have started discussing what is required. It will not take us more than 2-3 weeks for Cross Rivers to assess this fund. I hope we'll be able to put ourselves together in order for Cross Rivers to assess this fund. Your Excellency, I don't want to take your time much, but it's important also to assure Your Excellency that we at the Bank of Agriculture, we are trying to partner with both domestic as well as external partners In particular, we are anticipating some funding from the African Development Bank to the tune of about $150 to $200 million. We are also expecting the German Development Fund, as well as the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, to boost our fund for SMEs so that we'll be able to lend more. But also, Your Excellency, we are looking for a partnership with our Brazilian National Development Fund in order to ensure agricultural financing for equipment, leasing, and the supply of necessary inputs that are needed on a large scale for agricultural development in our country. We are repositioning the bank in terms of its risk management framework. We are upskilling the skills components of our staff. We are also improving on